Well, I don't know how good of a video this is. I'm sitting here. Last night, she wasn't able to stand up. She would just fall down. And then she started defecating on herself and yowling. She's been sick for a number of months, but with prednisone, she was eating and drinking and had her weight fully back up and was lapping as much as she always did. And she's lapping now, but she's dead. I took her into the emergency vet, and of course they euthanized her. She just went downhill so quick. About 4 o'clock in the afternoon, I was eating my dinner in a chair, TV tray, watching TV. She jumped up on the chair, sat behind me, laid down behind me. I sat forward on the chair, ate dinner. Later, she jumped down, went someplace. Maybe I was finished by 4:30, 4:45, went someplace. 7:30, it was time to give her prednisone, loaded it up. Then I went looking for her. Never was she wasn't in any of her regular spots. So I started taking my flashlight and shining everywhere I could think of that she could conceal herself. She was under my desk downstairs in my office. I don't ever recall her being there. On the way down to the stairs, I cleaned her cat box, and there were these little 4 or 5 little hard poops, and then there was one that was soft. She hasn't had a soft poop in years. Back downstairs, when I did find her under my desk, there was a soft poop under my desk, so I cleaned it up, then I grabbed her. She seemed to have less life than I can ever remember her having before. I took her upstairs. I gave her the prednisone, put her down, and she wobbled over to this cat seat, this comfortable thing near the TV. Later, I decided to put her on my lap. She just didn't look good. And I noticed that there was still some soft poop there on her. I put a paper towels underneath me and sat her, but then she snuggled her head, kind of wedged it between my body and the chair. So I repositioned her and put her on the floor and she fell over. Then she tried to get up and she kept kicking, and she'd get up and she would fall down and thrust forward. So I took her back to the back bathroom, where it was the smallest bathroom, and put her in there, and she was defecating. So I cleaned her up, but then she seemed in distress. She tried to get up, but she had run her head into the wall. I held her down for a little bit. She started yowling, and then she just complied. That's when I knew we were finished. Called the emergency vet. Had a hard time talking because I was crying. Went over there. They let me in. I waited so long. I was thinking, I want to put her down now, get her out of her misery. I opened up the cage door because her head was kind of pushed into it. She was looking at me. She yowled a little bit. I just petted her, tried to calm her down. Eventually they came in. They wouldn't let me go to the back. They put a catheter in her and brought her back. Then a veterinarian came in, asked for some history on her. I gave her the history. I was just thinking, let's get this thing on. And then she let out a really loud yowling. And the vet said that was common. I don't know what he meant, it was common. He asked me if I wanted time. I said, no, let's get it going. Why do I want time? Why do I want time? If I were out on a ranch by myself, I would have ended it really quickly. But this is a city. I had Janice to think about. But with what I saw, I knew the end was inevitable and that we should just end it now, as soon as possible. No more talking, no more waiting. Let's just get it on. So the vet did. He injected propofol. Then he cleared the line. Then he injected some other drug to stop the heart. It was stopped. Asked me if I wanted to wait for a few minutes with her. I said, no, I'm taking her. Asked me if I wanted a box. I said, no, I'm just taking her. I've got a towel here, I'm just taking her. Gave him my credit card, left, came home. I had an appointment for tomorrow. It was Wednesday when it happened. Today's Thursday, Thanksgiving. I have an appointment tomorrow with the vet because I was giving her an arthritic shot to sort of numb the nerves for arthritis. I'd given her one exactly 4 weeks ago to the day, once tomorrow comes, and it really did help her. She was having trouble jumping, and after 2 weeks, she was hopping back up on things, even though her back end had atrophied a lot. So I had scheduled to have another arthritic shot, forget the name of it right now, for tomorrow, but we didn't make it. Wrote the vet, told her what happened. She wrote a nice little email back. We really can't talk to people about it. Just start crying. She was a good cat. Got her over 14 years ago. More or less, I calculate her ages now is about 14 years, 6.5 months. Janice got her out at a farm, out at a ranch. She was crying behind some pallets and some hay bales. Janice went riding, came back. Cat was still yowling. She found the cat, picked it up, brought her home. Was going to look for the owner. But then she decided, hey, this cat's sick. Took her to the vet. She was sick. Doctored her up. Kept her. This cat knew how to, I don't know how old she was, 4 to 5 weeks. This cat knew how to use a litter box from day one. She never made a mistake with her litter box. What a good cat. Always went to her litter box. Only recently now, as she dragged some of her poops out of her litter box and one time peed in front of the litter box on the stairs. Good cat. Total lapper, just like she is right now. Almost wherever she was in the house, if I called her, she came. If she wanted. But invariably, she would eventually come and jump up on my lap, purr, fall asleep. That was her job, and she did it well.